Good to see you. You look great.
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
Last time I saw you was the big NBC party.
There was some big NBC party, and
announcing of the schedule.
Right. I was serving hors d'oeuvres there, actually, I remember. That was a fun party, though. Yeah. You seem to be having a good time.
Yeah.
And you got your own show now on NBC.
Yeah.
This is exciting.
Very exciting.
Are you hanging out with the? I mean, you've been a star for a while, but when you got your own show, are you hanging out with the big high-level stars now at big parties out in LA? What's it like?
Well, not really. I mean, the last big party I went to was the Waterworld premiere. I brought my sister.
The Waterworld premiere?
Hey, you know.
Was there money left for a party at that point?
it was like
bring your own beer to that party.
Well, my sister really wanted to go because she wanted to meet Kevin Costner. So we crashed the Waterworld premiere, and we went as tourists. I didn't want to go down the, you know, get my picture taken.
The red carpet and everything.
And then we were at the party, and she said, "Oh my God, it's Brad Pitt." And I was like, "Oh, what a dreamboat. He's so cute." And she wanted his autograph.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, I'll do it. And I walked up, "Brad, can I have your autograph?" And he went, "Oh my God, Leah Thompson." And he put his food down. And he said, "When I was young, I thought you were so cute."
Oh, no! No, what are you talking? What's he talking about?
I went like this.
No, he said that?
Oh, no.
You're very young. You're a youthful, beautiful woman in the prime of life.
I know, but I did Back to the Future 10 years ago, so, you know.
But that's just, I mean, how old is he? He's in his late 40s, isn't he, Brad Pitt?
No,
he's 48 years old. Who is he to be? That's just a fact. I'm not doing a joke or anything. I think he's actually 48.
He's the cutest thing in the world. I was so thrilled.
Is he disappointing at all in person? Please say yes.
No, he's a dream.
Really? Oh.
Yeah. But
guys always like to hear that the guy who everyone thinks is really handsome in real life, he's 4'5". He has a big dueling scar. He's got an eye patch.
Uh-uh.
He's got a beard like a pirate.
No, and it was really great because they put a picture of us talking in the Hollywood Reporter, and my husband saw it, so.
How did he respond to that?
He teases me about it now.
Oh, good. So a big fight didn't erupt.
No, he's so sweet. My husband's great.
Now, you've done many movies in your career, and we were talking today. It'd be an interesting question. Are there any movies that you didn't get? You know, you hear about these stories.
Oh.
Big stars that were up for movies that later went on to be big movies. Were you up for any movies that you didn't get that later went on to be something?
Oh, well, I have a really disastrous story. I went to audition for, what was it called? Pretty Woman. And I
Oh, yeah, that. What was it called? I think that was a pretty big movie. Remember that thing with the Julia Roberts, I don't really remember.
But the thing was, I read the script and it was a tragedy. I just thought it was like this docudrama about the pitfalls of being a streetwalker in LA. So I did this really, you know, intense audition. I had no idea it was a comedy.
Oh, God. What kind of, who's, wait a, who's managing you? What's happening here?
I don't know.
You showed up and then you just read it really intense?
Yeah, it was really intense, you know, tears and the whole bit. And I got the call from the agent. You know, it was a comedy. That was my interpretation of the script.
Was there someone there actually going after your... Oh, my God.
No, the chair just opened up and I went...
Oh, man. But that did you... So when you saw the movie, were you just completely shocked that...
I was. I was like, well, wrong choice. Wrong acting choice, Leah.
Well, you've made enough good acting choices in your career. You've got your show. We're actually doing your show. You guys shoot it in Los Angeles, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that a lot of these shows are done on a lot with a million other shows.
Oh, yeah, it's great. We're on the old MGM lot where there's Seinfeld, there's Sybil, there's Roseanne. Mm-hmm. All the shows are in one place, so it's kind of like the old MGM days.
You guys just hang out?
Oh, it's so cool.
Now, is it true that American Gladiators is done on your lot?
Yeah.
Someone told me, tell me about American Gladiators. What's that set like?
I want to be on American Gladiators. Well, you know, they shoot all the shows really quick, and then now there's another show there.
You mean not a lot of artistic integrity goes into that? Shooting of tennis balls at one another at high speeds? But I would think that would be a fun set. You know, you hear about all the sitcoms and all the, you know,
yeah.
It'd be fun to have the Seinfeld cast as a neighbor. I would think it would be fun to have American Gladiators as a neighbor.
Yeah, I think so. All those women in skimpy outfits and those buffed up dudes. Yeah, sharing the same restroom.
Wow, I think we're on to something here. It sounds like you know some really racy stories about the set. They're not for on-air consumption, though?
Yeah, right. No, no.
Okay. Right, we won't get into it. All right, now tell me quickly, because we're running a bit low on time, but I'm curious about, I know that when you were starting out in your career, it's very difficult when you're starting out as an actress. Mm-hmm. It's a hard thing to do to get started. You actually, is it true, you padded your resume a bit?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I had 2 fake movies. And the problem was...
Now, wait a minute here. You, but 2 fake movies? That's not padding your resume. That's called lying.
Don't try this at home. But the weird thing was that they both became movies. Yes.
I made up this thing, Waterworld, and then it happened.
It was Crossroads and The River, and they both became movies.
Wait, you made up the title, yeah, The River?
Yes. But this was 12 years ago, so it was really weird. So now people still find some old resume and they go, you were in Crossroads? No.
You can just do that. Do other people do that? Just make up stuff?
Well, I was young. I was foolish. What can I say?
I spent years telling people I was the original host of Jeopardy. And for a while, it worked. Everyone bought it. They're still buying it out there somewhere.